Welcome to Ghanaian Photography. My name is Don Alabi. I get lots of people coming to me to teach them how to use Capture One because I always talk about Capture One. And so today I've decided to take you through an introduction to Capture One. We'll go a bit in depth. So by just watching this tutorial, you should be able to start using Capture One with ease. We'll start by opening Capture One, creating a catalog, importing images, culling, a basic raw processing, and then basic export. Now, there are certain things which are much more advanced, which I've covered in other videos. So if you want to learn the much more advanced aspects of Capture One, I'll include some of the links in the description and then the playlist also. It has over 13 Capture One videos, which you can watch and then learn a couple of stuff. So we already have Capture One opened here. So we'll start by creating a catalog. So we go to File, New Catalog, and we'll give it a name. What I do is I have a catalog for each type of photography that I do. So I have personal projects, weddings, studio. There is no rule as to how you can name your catalog. It's up to you, the way you organize your files. People create one catalog for the year and then have folders in for each thing. I prefer creating a catalog for each genre of photography. So for this one, we'll just go ahead and create a dummy catalog. Let's call it tutorial. Now, where do we want to save this catalog? You need to find a place to save it. It all depends on how you organize your folders. So over here, I have it in my documents, a folder called catalogs. And in that catalogs folder, there are subfolders with the year. So with this one, I'll save it in 2021 and then choose. So we have the name of our catalog, the location. These are very necessary. So we click open. And voila, we have a blank catalog. So now we go to the next step, which is importing images. So over here, you can just click on this arrow and it will bring you to the import dialog. Or you can go to File and then you see import images. So you click on it, it brings you to the same place. Now here, there are different ways of importing. If you want to import from an SD card, from an external drive, or from your machine. So over here, we have import from, import to. These are the two important things you need to look at over here. So import from, where do you want the images to come from? So if you have an SD card, you slot it in, it will appear here. So you can choose whether your external drive, if you have your SD card inserted. I don't have my SD card inserted, so it won't show anything from there. Or if you have the images on your internal drive, you just navigate to wherever you have the images stored. So let's go to my external hard drive and then pick an image from there. So over here, we have this. So I'll pick this particular folder. So you choose the folder. You don't select the images here. Once you choose the folder, the imports window will load all the images for you, so you make your selection. So I'll just choose this, and then so you see it shows me all the images in that particular folder. So over here it has all of them selected already. Do I want all selected to be imported? No. If that's what you want, you just click on import. So after the images display here, now you would have to choose where you want the images to be imported to. So over here, the same thing, you go to copy to folder and then you navigate to where you want them copied to. Now this is a case where if you have your images on an external drive, but you don't want to work from the external drive, you want to move the images to your internal drive or a different location where you want to work from. Or a typical scenario is from your SD card. You want to import the images from the SD card onto your working SSD or an external. This is how you do it. So you select where you want it to be. In this case, I want the images to remain there. No, you know what? I'll move the images from where they are to a different location. So you see how it works. So let's say now I want the images to come to my desktop. Then I'll create a new folder called tutorial create. So we select as import folder. So you see it's moving it from the original place, which is Olivia, to our desktop, which has the folder tutorial. So now the images are all selected. Do I want to import all? If that's the case, you just press import all and everything goes. But I don't want all the images imported. So I will click on this, the pick all. So it deselects everything. So now I will go through and then choose the images I want to import. So let's say I want this. Can just select it here. Or this, select it. So you see, as you select, it shows the check mark. Say this one here. And then let's say this one. So we've selected how many images? 4 images. Now we are ready to import them. So we go here. Now there are other things over here which are much more advanced. You don't really need them like as a basic user. So later I'll do a tutorial to explain all these things in detail. But for now, for a basic import, these are the 2 things you need: the import from and then the import to. So let's click on import 4 images. Et voila. So you see, we have our 4 images imported in here. Congratulations, you've successfully imported your first images into Capture One. Now we move to the next stage, which is culling. Culling has to do with you going through your images and then deleting bad ones, keeping the good ones, and even with the good ones, making your final selection. You can use star ratings or color tags to separate the images. I have a tutorial on how to do these things, so don't forget, the links will be in the description, so you can check them out after watching this video. So let's go through. Now these 2 images look the same. So I'll say I want to keep this and delete this one. So just press delete and this goes. Voila. So we have this, this and that. So let's say we want to keep these 3 images and then work on them. So the next stage is raw process. So over here you're seeing the raw images. These are straight out of camera, how they were shot from the camera. If you look on the left here, everything is flat. See, and also I have a video on how to do advanced raw processing. So don't forget, this particular video is for, you know, it's an introductory video. It's just to introduce you to Capture One, how to get you started quickly. If you want in-depth videos, the links are in the description, so you can always check them out. Everything here is raw. So let's say we go in a bit like this, 10, then bring this down, come here, we'll increase it a bit. Now do some basic raw processing. And I think so far, this is good. So one thing people keep asking me is, Capture One, how do you apply your processing for one image to other image, like batch processing? Because it's easier in Lightroom, so they say. I have never used Lightroom, so I can't tell. But it's very easy copying adjustments in Capture One and replicating them on other images. Now if you look up here, there are 2 arrows. One is copy, one is apply. So if we are okay with the adjustments we made to this image, we just copy this. Now we move to the next image and then apply. So you see all that we did on the other image have been applied to this particular image. But note that the environment isn't the same, so you would have to come back here and then readjust some of them in order to get the exact thing you need. But this is just to show you that you can always work on one image, copy the adjustments and then paste it on a couple of other images. Simple as that. So let's correct this here and let's see, once we are done with this, so this, with this one, we are okay with the adjustment. So we copy it, and since this is in the same environment, once we paste, you see, then we can come to levels, and then, so if you need any minor adjustment to the individual image, you can do so after applying the adjustments from the previous image. It works the same way for events. So most people think Capture One is for portraiture. No, you can use it for events. I use Capture One for all my raw processing, for weddings, events, anything at all, I use it for that. So basically, we've raw processed our images. So now, after raw processing, what else do you do? You export the image. So before we export, let me show you cropping. Now you see we have empty spaces and all that. If you want to crop this image to, you know, a certain aspect ratio, if you come up here, there is the crop tool here. So if you click on the arrow here, it gives you a whole lot of aspect ratios. So for Instagram, it's 4x5. Once you do that, and then you click anywhere, or you can click on anywhere on the image and then draw, or you can just click at the edge and it will automatically snap into position for you. So once you do that, you can always click and then drag. Once you're done, you press enter, it gives you the crop you need. So let's say we do it for this one. Now if you don't want to use the aspect ratios, you can go to unconstrained and then, you know, draw anyhow you want. See, so if this is what we want, we can do this and then come here like this, move it here a bit, enter. See, so we've been able to crop our images to our taste and then to the predefined aspect ratio. So the next thing is to export. Now the way you export in Capture One is a bit advanced. We have the advanced and then the basic one. If you do export more times, then you want to have recipes which will save your export settings, so you can apply that same setting to multiple images and you are able to export within the shortest possible time and with ease. I have a tutorial on how to use recipes to export from Capture One, so you know where to find it, right? Awesome. So here you can just right click on this and then export. We have originals and variants. Originals, the raw images. So when you export the originals, it means you've exported the, you want to export the raw images, not without the adjustments that you've applied. Now the variants means what we have here, what we've raw processed. I hope you understand the difference between originals and variants. So if you click on variants, it comes here, then destination, you choose where you want to send it. So let's choose, we have a folder on the desktop called tutorial. So over here we have this, so we select export to that, and then there is a subfolder. Do you want to store it in a subfolder, let's say a subfolder called Instagram or Facebook? If that's what you want to save it to, you can do that. Now this is exporting one by one. You want to save time so that, you know, you can get enough time to do other stuff. You don't want to be doing this for each image. So let's cancel this. And then we go to this wrench button here. That's the output. You click on it. So here we have what we call process recipes. These recipes, some of them come by default and then some you create yourself. My tutorial talks about how to create them, so it will be down there in the description. Now I have, these are the recipes I use most of the time. Web address, which has my website URL on. Then I have portfolio and then the full JPEG. Nothing reduced. So once you're here, you select the recipes you want to use. Now, the good thing about Capture One recipes is that all you have to do is select the various recipes. And when you click on process, it creates individual folders for each of those recipes. So if we have these three selected and we export, it's going to have three different folders. One called web address, portfolio, and then JPEG. And all these have different settings. They have different values, different output settings. I mean, what else would you want if you don't want to use it? I'm not sure Lightroom has something like this. So once you choose your recipes, you come to your output location. You choose where you want your images exported to. So here we have desktop tutorial. Then you click select. So over here we have web address, portfolio, JPEG. Now let's select all these three images and then process and see the magic. So we see this status bar filling up. Once it's done exporting, we'll go blank again. Awesome. So this is done. Now if we go to our desktop, let me open this folder and drag it here. If we come here, okay, so I've noticed a mistake here. There's something we didn't do in there. So let's go fix that up. Then we'll come back to this. So let's take this here. Now over here, when we were exporting, you see subfolder. We did not specify a subfolder where the individual images should go. So over here, let's look for recipe name. So recipe name means what? The name of the recipe. So to create a subfolder with the name of the recipe. Hope I haven't confused you guys. So now let's go to process and then see what happens. So let's bring back this. And then over here, you see we have three folders, JPEG, portfolio, and web address, which correspond to the recipe names over here. Easy. So if you open web address and open this image, see, there's an image there with my web address on it. If you go back to portfolio, it has no watermark on it. And then if we open the other folder, which is full size. Now, if you look at it, see, this is the full resolution. You get it. So this makes it easy using Capture One. So this has been your basic introduction to Capture One. If this has been helpful to you, go ahead and drop your thumbs up, like the video, and share it with people who you know will benefit from this. I hope this has been informative for you, and I would like to thank you for watching.